The Genome of Europe is the second funded project, which is creating genome data across all these countries. So together, this project will really make at least 1 million genomes accessible for research and healthcare purposes. My name is André Uytterlinde. I'm a professor of complex genetics here at Erasmus Medical Center in Rotterdam, the Netherlands. And I'm investigating the genetic basis of disease, in particular common diseases. The first time I was intrigued was at high school when we had a quite modern biology teacher who mentioned DNA, and that since then has always kept intriguing me. And that led me to study biology, and in particular molecular biology, where I specialized in molecular genetics and eventually got me a job looking into this fantastic molecule. The Genome of Europe project is part of the 1 Million Genomes initiative, which was launched in 2018. My role is the one of coordinator. I launched the idea in the 1 Million Genomes initiative, and luckily we were awarded with some money by the European Commission, and I wrote the grant together with my team and together with many other people collaborating on this. The Genome of Europe is particularly focused on creating data for reference purposes. It's a large-scale collaboration between countries voluntarily to make 1 million genomes at least accessible for research and for use in healthcare and prevention. The immediate use of the Genome of Europe data will be in lookup of variants, which other people find in their research and clinical diagnostics, just to check has that variant seen before elsewhere in Europe. But on the longer term, I think it will serve a big role in setting up genomic infrastructures in countries, where it is not the case yet, to make use of this information to improve lives of people. Many people have some fears about DNA information. They see it as sort of destiny. Although it is the blueprint of life, there are many things you can do once you know your risk. We have many ways of, let's say, mitigating that risk. We have lifestyle advice that can help you to lower your cholesterol by changing your diet, for example. We have medication to lower that. By having this genetic information, it can help them to prevent much worse things happening, like cardiovascular events, which are terrible for the person, but also very costly for society. We have set up these collaborations with the sequencing technology providers such as Illumina in the Genome of Europe project, especially to make use of the latest possibilities that technology is allowing us to do in the case of sequencing whole genomes of humans. They are really excelling in terms of the quality of the stuff they are delivering and the type of technology they are offering. It's an ecosystem where we feed each other, we tell them what we would like to see happening, and they of course are offering this so we can proceed with our research and make fantastic discoveries, and in the end help healthcare to be much better and more widespread. What's next? Well, we now have funding to generate 100,000 genomes, which is not a million. So we want to create more of such reference genomes, and there's a real need for that, because at the moment with the current funding we can only make reference genomes of a certain number of population subgroups living in Europe, so we need more money to generate more reference genomes. But I also see an opportunity to make use of the data that we will be creating and also the infrastructure that will be set up to start really implementing the use of genomic information in healthcare and prevention. So we are discussing now ideas along those lines with the European Commission to see how can we organize such implementation phase of the use of genetic information.